Shalom, brethren, in the mighty name of Jesus. I come today with much excitement, but also responsibility on this great revelation that I'm going to share today. The Lord had revealed to me this great revelation since 1 year ago. I didn't disclose it to anyone because I needed several confirmation from the Lord. Since 1 year, the Lord had revealed to me the Elijah to come. And I saw him in my hotel room. He appeared in my hotel room, apparently with an angel. And when I tried to look, he sat, you know, on the chair that was right opposite the bed of my hotel room. He was dressed in white clothes, and I saw him. He is walking among us, one of the persons that we've been seeing, you know, preaching the word of God everywhere, you know, and announcing that the Messiah is coming. But when I saw that, when the Lord indicated to him that this is the Elijah that I promised in the book of Malachi, chapter 4, verse 5 to 6, I was, you know, trembling. I was in shock. When I came to myself, it was a vision. So I stood up, I went on my knees to start praying to God to reveal unto me if indeed this servant of God was the Elijah to come, if it was not what I saw, it was not from the enemy. So it took me some time. I've been praying about it and seeking the Lord in prayer. And to my surprise, another man of God, a pastor, came to me, you know, after a month running to say that the Lord had, you know, presented to him the same servant of God, you know, before his presence, and told him how he was, you know, the Elijah that was promised in the Bible. Brethren, before I disclose to you how the Lord confirmed to me again and again, you know, this revelation, I would like to go with you in the Bible and let us check what are the characteristics. What are the ways we should know that indeed the Elijah is with us? But the Bible promises that indeed when Elijah would be here, nobody would know. And that is what I'm going to show you in the Bible. Open your Bible. Let us open our Bibles in the book of Malachi chapter 4, verses 5 and 6. It says, "Behold, I will send you Elijah the prophet before the coming of the great and dreadful day of the Lord. And he shall turn the hearts of the father to the children, and the hearts of the children to the father, lest I come and smite the earth with a curse." So here, the prophet Malachi announced the coming of the Elijah, you know, before the great and dreadful day of the Lord. Brethren, if you look in the Bible, when Jesus was born, it was not the great and dreadful day of the Lord. It was, in fact, the good news to the whole world. The Bible says that this was good news, you know, for Jesus, the Messiah, the Savior, was born. The great and dreadful day of the Lord would be the day where the world would be mourning and some few would be rejoicing. And I believe very much that the great and dreadful day of the Lord is the day that the rapture is going to take place. Many in the church will be left behind. There will be a great earthquake. The Bible says that the firmament of the air, the heavens, you know, will roll like a carpet. And it will be 3 days darkness immediately after the rapture takes place. So this is the great and dreadful day of the Lord, which is going to take place. But before this day takes place, you know, there must be the coming of the Elijah, which means that this person, this servant of God, would come in the spirit of Elijah, you know, and doing all things that Elijah did. You know, his function would return the hearts of the father to the children and the hearts of the children to the father. You know, and anyone that would not listen or any nation that would not obey, you know, would be struck by a curse or by some kind of disaster, which is the curse, you know, coming from the living God. But I don't stop from there. I would like us to see the first time that Elijah came to this earth. Let us open the book of Matthew, chapter 11, verse 10 to 13. Let me open here using Matthew, chapter 11, verses 10 to 13. It says, "For this is he of whom it is written, Behold, I send you a messenger before thy face, which shall prepare the way before thee. Verily I say unto you, among them that are born of women, there has not risen a greater than John the Baptist. Notwithstanding, he that is least in the kingdom of heaven is greater than he. And from the days of John the Baptist until now, the kingdom of heaven suffered violence, and only the violent take it by force. So you can see here, you know, that John the Baptist came in the spirit and anointing of Elijah. He walked, you know, not eating ordinary food, but eating locust and honey, and living mostly in the desert, and preaching to people in the desert about repentance. What was the message of John the Baptist? John the Baptist came with a message. Let me take my notes so that you may know. I put it very clearly the way the Lord had revealed to me. The first message that John the Baptist came to preach, it was, you know, the kingdom of God is at hand. You know, John the Baptist was saying that the kingdom of God is at hand. That was the message he was transmitting. And the second message was repentance of sin. So John the Baptist was preaching repentance of sin. The third message that John the Baptist was preaching was prepare the way of the Lord and make straight his paths. You know, the fourth message, it was that you know, fathers should repent and children should repent and come to the Lord Jesus. That was retaining the heart of the children to the father, and here the father to the children, reconciliation of the church to the Lord Jesus Christ. You know, reconciliation of the children that are in the church to the Father God, to the Trinity of God. And the fifth message that John was preaching, he was rebuking sin in the church. He was rebuking sin in the lives of Pharisees and Sadducees. The Pharisees and Sadducees today represent the false teachers, the false pastors, the prosperity preaching, you know, sow a seed and, you know, you will be blessed. You know, today the gospel has been exchanged, you know, totally. People are preaching to seek first the kingdom of the earth and all its wealth, and then the kingdom of heaven will be added unto you. So they are, you know, they bring anointing oil from Israel, and they say this is the anointing oil of the Holy Spirit. If you buy it, you'll be most blessed. These are the false messages that is going on. Instead of preaching sin, instead of preaching iniquity, for people to run away from the wrath to come. The sixth message, John the Baptist came to advise or to admonish the church to bring forth fruit worthy of repentance. These were the six messages that John the Baptist brought. And we can see where, again, you know, the Lord God reaffirmed through the Lord Jesus Christ about the promise of the second Elijah to come. So come with me again to the book of Matthew, chapter 17, from verses 10 to 12. Verse 10 says, and his disciple asked him, saying, why then the scribe say that Elijah must come first? And Jesus answered and said unto them, Elijah truly shall come first, so, and restore all things. So you can see Jesus said that before his coming to rapture the church, to take the church in the time of the wedding feast of the Lamb, Elijah must come first. You know, the coming of Elijah this time to restore all things that have been lost by the church. So the church have lost everything. Humanity have lost everything concerning the gospel of the cross and the blood, concerning the gospel of repentance, concerning the gospel of truth, the gospel which brings the heart to repent, the heart to turn unto God the Father, the heart of the children to turn unto the living God. So this gospel has been lost. Now the gospel of the cross has been lost. Today the gospel is mild. You know, you put, you know, is fast food today. The gospel that is being preached on the pulpit, it is a promise. You will be promoted. Everybody say amen. Of course, promotion comes from the Lord alone. But when you seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, promotion and all financial blessings, these are bonus. They should run after you. You don't run after them. So you see that the Lord Jesus said that truly Elijah must come first to restore all things. But I say unto you that Elijah had already come, but they knew him not, but have done unto him whatsoever they listed. And likewise shall also the Son of Man suffer of them. So you can see that when John the Baptist came, as Elijah promised in the book of Malachi, people didn't know this is Elijah. See, this was the question that intrigued me. I started asking God. When God presented unto me the Elijah that was promised in my hotel room in Luanda, Angola, I was very surprised. I said, God, can you really confirm this unto me? And when God revealed this unto me, he said, yes, truly, Elijah must come first to restore all things. And people would not know when Elijah would come. You know, so I started, you know, seeking God on this. So you can see the Lord Jesus promised this in the word of God. You see, there are several scriptures, even Moses, you know, prophesied about a prophet like unto him would rise up. You can confirm that yourself. You can read it in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 18, verses 15 to 19. And even Peter, when he was preaching on the speech in that day, you know, he also spoke about it. So you can confirm this in the book of Acts of Apostles chapter 3, verse 21 to 23. You know, we see also Stephen, you know, in his speech, reaffirmed this prophecy in the book of Acts of Apostles chapter 7, verse 37. Acts 7:37. So the prophecy is well affirmed in the Bible. So when the Lord gave me the vision and showed me this man of God has the Elijah that was promised, and he has been here on earth preaching repentance, preaching for the people, you know, to come unto the Lord, to prepare the way of the Lord and make straight his path. So who is this man that the Lord has revealed unto me? And since 1 year ago, I've been fasting and praying about this. Now that I've been authorized by the Lord, I met this man of God. I spoke to him, and indeed he confirmed unto me that the church should have known this for a long time, through the signs, through what is going on, through the Bible, through prayer, through revelation, through fasting, you know. And he even told me, you know, you don't need my son for you to announce this to humanity. I begged him. I said, I need to tell the church that indeed Elijah that was promised is here, but the church does not know, as it is written in the Bible. You know, and he told me, but maybe the Lord has blinded their understanding that they may not see, seeing that they may not see, hearing that they may not hear. I said, Papa, I need to announce to the world that indeed we are at the brink of the Bible prophecy. Elijah has been here for many years, but people do not know. People, the church does not know that Elijah is here. The church does not know that the rapture is going to take place any moment now. The church does not know that the prophetic timeline and God, there remain nothing but the wedding feast of the Lamb. So I sat with him. So who is this man, brethren? I know you are very anxious to know who is this servant of God that the Lord revealed unto me and that the Lord confirmed through many people. I had a brother also who saw the same vision. So brethren, I am talking to you with much deep responsibility to transmit this word of God. I don't exalt man, but I stand for the truth of the word of God. So brethren, I want to present unto you that the person that the Lord presented unto me in several visions, the second time I had the vision, you know, was when I went to meet this man of God, you know, to try to talk to him. I was in the hotel room after, you know, having the first contact from the airport, you know, where I arrived. You know, he appeared again in my room with some angels that looked like young angels. And he appeared in my room, and he laid his hand high over my head, and he was praying very seriously and prophesying. This God presented unto me Prophet Dr. David Owour in my room as the Elijah to come. And at that time, I didn't know him very well. So when the Lord showed Dr. David Owour in my room as the Elijah, I was very surprised. So I started praying about it. The day I met him face to face, you know, I knew indeed that the revelation that God gave me is true. You know, I told some pastors who went to pray about it, and they confirmed. So what was his calling? You see, so you can see, I compared the message he's preaching. I compared his characteristics. I compared his way of life. You know, I compared his life. So I really searched God. I sought God about it since 1 year ago that the Lord, you know, had revealed me that this is the Elijah to come. Look, if you look and you want to research about him, if you want to pray about it, and I'm very sure the Lord is going to confirm also to you. You know, if the Lord confirmed it to me because I've been seeking about this, because I've been praying about this, He is surely going to confirm it to you, brother. So the first message that the prophet David Owour is preaching is repentance of sin in the church. The second message is to prepare the way of the Lord, you know, for the coming of the Messiah. The third message, it is holiness and righteousness, without which nobody will see God. The fourth message is the rapture of the church. You know, the fifth message is restore the church back to Christ. So he has been preaching, and you see the signs. You see, you know that he has prophesied Katrina. You know he has prophesied IT earthquake, Chile earthquake, Japanese earthquake, financial crisis. You know he has prophesied China and Russia earthquake, Iran earthquake. You know he has prophesied Irene. He has prophesied, you know, all the hurricane disasters in the U.S. He has prophesied most of the prophecies of disaster going on, the aviation disasters, you know, the cloud hushes in Europe, in the UK and Iceland. You know all these prophecies are the sign, you know, that God has put in him. When the Lord called him, that video interview YouTube is available. You can search how the Lord called him. When the Lord called him, he presented the Ark of the Covenant in the middle. On the other side were seated Moses and Daniel. On the other side was seated Elijah, and he came to sit. You know, and the glory of God came to sit on the Ark of the New Covenant. And the voice of the Lord spoke, you know, out of the glory, saying, now I have my fourth prophet here. And you, David Owour, you are the fourth one. And power has been given unto you. So this is a man that I've met personally that is not normal at all. He lives in the presence of God 24 hours. His life is absolute holiness. You see in him there is righteousness. This is he that the Bible promises. If I come to talk to you, brethren, it's because I have seen it. It's because the Lord has shown to me in vision. It's because the Lord has revealed to me. And I sat with him. This time I went to Kakamega Revival, and I had a private time with the prophet of the Lord. And I spoke to him about this issue. And he clearly told me, indeed, the church should have known. The church should have known that indeed the Elijah is here, the message that he's bringing, the sign that he's bringing, and the message he's bringing to restore the church. Brethren, wake up. Church, wake up. We have in our midst for many years now, Elijah the prophet prophesied in the word of God that he would come to restore all things. So you can see the calling and the message of prophet David Owour has indeed the message of Elijah, has indeed the message of John the Baptist, has indeed the message of Moses, the power of Moses, the fire that comes with him. So brethren, I have never seen a man like the prophet David Owour in my whole life. I've been a missionary. I've been preaching everywhere the word of God. I've been an evangelist. You know, brethren, I have never seen. I normally don't exalt any man. This is not to exalt men, but to reveal to the church that indeed the Elijah promised in the Bible is here with us, preaching repentance of sin, preaching sin, to, you know, preaching that people should run away from sin, embrace holiness, embrace righteousness, because the Messiah is coming. He is the one that the Lord is using in our times, you know, has a hand and the mouth of the Lord. This is why you can see revival breaking powerfully in Kenya and all over the world. I went to Angola with him personally, and I saw again how the Lord presented to him. This is the larger. It looks like the Lord connected me to the prophet of the Lord, you know, for me to see that my questions I've been asking God for a long time have come to be answered. And the Lord answered this question of mine in a very powerful manner. Personally, and even in a vision, and even how the Lord presented to him in about two times, you know, that this is the Elijah. You know, the Lord came and said, lo and behold, the question we've been asking, Elijah is here, that I have sent on the earth, you know, to turn the hearts of the father to the children, and the heart of the children to the father, to restore all things in the church, to restore holiness and righteousness in the church. So brethren, I am warning you, any time from now the rapture will take place. Brethren, wake up, for the Messiah is coming in all holiness and in all righteousness. So this is the message that I brought, brethren. So you can see the prophetic signs that are in the life of the mighty prophet of the Lord, Prophet David Owour. He is the mouth and hand of the Lord on earth right now to execute the end time prophecies. And indeed, you can see from the four apocalypse horsemen how the Lord took him before the throne and released one by one apocalypse horsemen. So many people in the church, they do not know that one of the four, you know, four of the seven horses in the book of Revelation chapter 6 have been already released on the face of the earth. That's what, if you don't know, I advise you to check, you know, repentance website of the prophet of the Lord. One of the second sign is the prophecy disasters that I've already said, that, you know, the nations who do not repent, the nations where he is declaring repentance do not repent. So you can see the disaster that is hitting them. One of the biggest example is the IT and Chile earthquake. No, miracles and signs happening. I've seen 31 cases of HIV positive healed in Kenya, proven by the CDC Atlanta laboratory and proven by the World Health Organization. Brethren, so you can see that indeed the Bible is true, and my questions have been answered by the Lord for a long time, that I've been asking for the Lord to reveal this one, and the Lord has brought him to revelation. So this is the message that I have brought to you. This is the warning, brethren. Wake up and tell everybody that indeed, at any time, the Messiah will take the church. Shalom.